What is the Tacoma lifespan and what's likely to go wrong with it? Well, good morning, everybody. How are you today? Pretty good here. It's a gorgeous sunny day here in the RGV in South Texas. Thought it'd be a good time to get on here and talk about the average lifespan of the Toyota Tacoma and what is likely to go wrong with it. You know, right now with the ongoing seemingly shortage of Toyota Tacomas, this is something that you have to think about, right? Particularly if you have a Tacoma that's 4, 5, 6, maybe 10 years old, and you were really looking to swap it out, go in, pick up a new one, but you can't find one, right? So let's take a look. The reported Tacoma lifespan is up to 200,000 miles, possibly even a little longer with regular maintenance and repairs. Now, what they say, or what does this mean, I guess, is that if you drive 20 to 30,000 miles, that's per year, of course, the Tacoma should live 10 to 15 years without major repairs. Of course, you can stretch it longer. Obviously, if you replace stuff, it's going to last longer. And you know, that's something I always found interesting about the Honda product, right? Particularly the Honda minivans. You know, back when minivans were a real booming popular thing, Honda used to tout that theirs lasted forever. Well, or somewhere in that range, right? But interestingly, their maintenance schedule was amazingly involved. Seemed like you had to take that thing in all the time, and they were always replacing parts on it. And you paid for that, right? After the warranty was up. So I don't know how you can really say that it lasted a long time when, in essence, you just continually repair or replace parts. Well, of course it'll last forever. You're always putting new stuff on it, right? I always thought that was kind of funny. So what are the regular repairs and maintenance for the Toyota Tacoma? We're going to break this down generally just a little bit as compared to miles or mileage, I guess. First of all, 10,000 miles. You're supposed to get an oil change and a new oil filter. One would hope you'd get a new filter when you get the oil change, right? At 15,000 miles, and this is for four-wheel drive, you're supposed to have a four-wheel drive propeller shaft lube and retorque. Also, front differential oil change. That's at 15,000 miles. Now, at 20,000 miles, you're supposed to replace the cabin air filter. This, I think, is stretching it just a bit. You know, I had replaced mine, or at least took a look at it, I should say, at probably around, I don't know, maybe 3,000 miles, something like that. And it had a bunch of stuff in it. Now, we do get a lot of pollen here. And of course, it depends on what you're doing with the truck and where you live. I mean, if you're out on dusty trails every day, you're probably going to be changing that thing, or you should, well before 20,000 miles. Just a normal environment, I would say probably at every oil change, you should take a look at it. Doesn't mean you need to change it, but take it out, beat it on something a couple of times to shake out whatever's in it, and you'll be surprised at what accumulates in there. You wouldn't think so, but there are things that will be in it. So just beat it off a little bit and then stick it back in there, right? You should be fine. At 30,000 miles, the engine air filter. Now, this, I think, is highly dependent upon where you live and what you're doing, right? Again, if you're out cruising the dusty trails, that thing is going to get dirty well before 30,000 miles. In my Gladiator, with just about, I think it was about 5,000 miles, something like that, I looked at the air filter, the engine air filter that I had put in aftermarket, and it was pretty dirty. So I actually changed that at 5,000 miles. Again, depends on what you're doing with the truck. 60,000 miles, you're supposed to replace the spark plugs and have a drive belt inspection, because obviously belts are going to wear. They're going to stretch. They might have some little nicks in them. They're just rubber. They're probably going to degrade as well. So take a look at those, and a fuel line check. Again, that's just to make sure that your fuel line is still viable, doesn't have any cracking or leaks. You know, the last thing you want to have happen is to be sitting on the side of the road watching your shiny Tacoma go up in flames because there was some sort of a fuel line leak. That's at 60,000 miles. Of course, it's rinse and repeat after that. You know, the next 10,000, the next 15,000, the next 20,000. If you do those things, these are just general repair and maintenance items. They say it should last up to 300,000 miles for 15 years. I don't think I've ever had, matter of fact, I know I've never had a vehicle 15 years. Average yearly repair and maintenance cost. So what is it gonna cost you to do all those things? It's not that high, $478. Again, that's an average based on that complete total time period. Now, I thought it'd be interesting to kind of compare that to just a couple other brands. I chose the Jeep Gladiator because I have a Jeep Gladiator. The average yearly cost for that, of the Jeep Gladiator, is $916.20. Now, by Wrangler standards, because we don't have any Gladiators that have been out there for more than 2 years, they're supposed to last, again, this is looking at it as compared to the Jeep Wrangler itself, 10 to 15 years. That's the life expectancy of the Jeep Gladiator. So obviously a bit less than the Toyota Tacoma, potentially. The Ford Ranger, $615 per year. That's the average repair and maintenance cost with a lifespan of 20 years. So about 5 years longer than the Jeep Gladiator. So what's most likely to go wrong with the Tacoma? And this is just a general look, right? I mean, obviously, there can be things here or there that different owners might experience. But generally, for the Toyota Tacoma, model years 1995 through 2007, lower ball joints. That was the predominant problem or failure with that date range for the Toyota Tacoma. Beyond that, the most complained about problem anyway, I don't know that I'd really call this a failure because it's not really a failure, but it's the transmission. You know, people really don't like the more modern, anyway, transmissions in the Toyota Tacoma. Lots of complaints about gear hunting, about it never being able to find the right gear when you're going uphill or going downhill or towing or whatever. Big complaints about the transmission. Now, I'm curious, because again, I'm guilty of this. I don't have my trucks for very long, right? I mean, I think the longest I've had one in recent times is probably a couple of years. And in just shy of, 10, 11 months, all I've had this truck, this Toyota Tacoma, it's a 2020, for 2 years. So it's going to take over the record for me here soon. But how long do you folks keep your trucks? Your Toyota Tacomas. And I'm wondering if this shortage that's out there, and even if you can find one, some dealers are adding premiums, but has that led you to keep your Toyota Tacoma longer? And maybe some of these life expectancy and projected repair costs come into play. I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, I have two additional channels. The first is RobMotive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. And the second is RobMotive Civic, about my experiences with the Honda Civic Type R and the Honda Civic Sport Hatchback. Check them out if you're interested. Please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.